Hi, this is Fender. I want to wish all you good people out there and the bad ones, we're all human, a very Merry Christmas, a Happy Hanukkah, and whatever else you believe in. Me, I believe I'll have another Coca-Cola later on today. Now, the Pakistanis and people, they want to. And Iran stone people because some Christian woman over there blasphemous about Muhammad the prophet. Excuse me. They never stop being blasphemous towards other religions. And, I don't know. I think personally, hesitating to condemn or generalize, I've yet to see Pakistan as a friend of the West. I think that General Petraeus and Obama that should literally invade the Waristan area and keep sending those drones in, blow away those bad people. Excuse me. Excuse me. That want to attack us all the time. And that's what I think. And I think if Obama bin Laden is hiding anywhere, it's got to be in that region. Maybe moving around from house to house, mosque to mosque. I also believe, and I'm only one British citizen, but after all, folks, our soldiers are fighting and dying in a war which was instigated by the United States. Like it, hate it, love it, or whatever. All this emulated because a group of Saudi people decided they would spend their valuable time manifesting a way to fly aircraft into the two most prominent buildings in the United States and possibly the Western world, the World Trade Center. They tried before in the basement, they failed, and into the Pentagon and into, well, that field in Pennsylvania, those brave people stopped them. But my guess is the last one was for the White House. Yeah, that, glad they stopped them. And I think, personally, that all the Islamic fanatics that want to believe, that have been brainwashed their whole lives into believing in their religion. No problem with that. They can believe in trees, walls, or white cliffs if they want it. It's not the point. It's the terrible, violent things they do. This has been going on for so many years. It's unbelievable. If they want to get voted in their country, they should declare it an Islamic state like Iran, and they should simply do whatever they want to do. That's their business. Not ours, and leave us decadent infidels alone to enjoy our Christmas tree or whatever. I also believe that Harry Truman was a great American, even though my sons are married to Japanese. I think that if he hadn't had done what he did, and I wish he'd have done it in less habitated islands as a warning, that the Japanese soldiers would still be fighting in their 80s because they believed in what they were. They believed the emperor was a living god. He claimed responsibility publicly over the air for the war, and he could have stopped it. Like that, stop. No one's going to argue with a guy like that. And I think he and all the others should have been arrested and tried as war criminals like the Germans, but not war. I had no power over. And what else? I believe no matter what happens in Afghanistan or Iraq, whether it's this year, next year, 10 years, they're going to keep coming, keep fighting, keep going, because these people in the Muslim world, and I'm not saying that all Muslims or Islamics are aggressive, violent, dangerous people, under, but in the Islamic, the Muslim world, within the Muslim world, there is no such thing. As far as I, as one Westerner, is concerned, and journalist and broadcaster, as moderation or leniency? Is it up with the head, stoning women, raping little girls of 9 years old? I mean, if that's what they want to do in their country, I got no problem, as long as they don't bring it to our countries. Now, I believe, and I want to make no hesitation on making my personal viewpoints very public, that if there is another really big violent attack on the West, like 9/11, like 7/7, where they people are going to keep blowing us up and destroying us and attacking us, regardless to their rhetoric or their reasons or their limited intellectual justifications, that the United States and Britain and the coalition should seriously consider a massive invasion of the areas where these people seem to have some kind of safe house mentality, protectionism. And if that doesn't work, we should even consider dropping a nuclear weapon or something on those areas. Now, I know this is a terrible thing to resort to, but we have to survive. We have to protect our loved ones and families. Harry Truman knew that, and that's why Harry Truman had to make a terrible decision with the Enola Gay when he dropped those bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. And I hope that the Japanese people and the rest of the world can understand why he did it. It would have cost maybe hundreds of thousands and millions of more of American and Western lives. And we must remember that the Japanese conduct, even though it was 60, 70 years ago, towards all their Asian Pacific neighbors and Pearl Harbor and to the wounded poor POWs who were bayoneted and butchered because they couldn't keep up in the Bataan Trail and what they did in Nanking, cannot just be wiped from history, and they should tell their kids about it before their children go and study overseas in places like America, Australia, Canada, New Zealand, and England, and see the movies about Pearl Harbor and what was done. Anyway, I'm not on that subject right now. I just wanted to conclude and make this a fairly short thing. I don't see any end in sight to these wars in Iraq or Afghanistan. I went on YouTube, I think, nearly 2 years ago, as people know, and made it very clear that I predicted this was going to be a perpetually endless engagement. We have lost so many thousands of lives in the West of people who will not be enjoying their freedom and the love of their families and loved ones and friends this Christmas, this Hanukkah, this whatever. Also Osama bin Laden, Al-Qaeda, and the other jihadist lunatics, which I think it depicts them correctly, have caused more harm to Islam, to Muhammad, to their Quran and their religion, and caused more absolute hatred and contempt towards the Muslim people and the Arab people and the Islamic people of the world than anything in thousands of years. You have a good one. Come visit me again.